When I had done the Jesus Christ Superstar album, I had an opportunity to meet Andrew Lloyd Webber and Tim Rice, and actually went to the premiere of the first live performance of Jesus Christ Superstar at St. Peter's Cathedral in New York. What should you want to know? Don't you mind about the future? As I was working more and more on the album, I got introduced to Robert Stigwood, who was friends, I guess, with Andrew Lloyd Webber. And when the album became a play, Robert Stigwood was the guy that was producing it. So he reached out to me because I had done the album and the libretto and all that stuff. And he wanted me to design the program for the show. And that's when it was going on the road. And so I got a chance to work with Robert for, I don't know, 2 or 3 months as a freelance project. And that kind of happened as I was moving to Craig Braun. I had just finished leaving the agency that I was at and working on that at the same time, and went to Craig Braun, and then came back out to LA, and we started Pacific Ioneer in 1972. And about a year or two later, I hadn't heard from Bob Stigwood in a few years, and I get a call from him one day. And he, you know, we catch up pretty quickly, and you know, how's it going and all that. And then he said, I'm involved with a band that I want to do a logo for, and I think you're the guy to do it. And that was the Bee Gees album. It was the main course album. But they really loved what I did, and that logo, and we did the main course album, and that was a big album for them in the disco world. That logo is still pretty synonymous. It's lettering that I designed just for them, and an alphabet that I didn't even really create the whole alphabet. It's just their name. And I've seen other people where they've taken and promoted a Bee Gees thing, and they'll do a takeoff on the lettering that I did for their logo. And it always seems to come up short. You know, that happens a lot. Black Sabbath was another one that I did a logo for the Sabbath Bloody Sabbath album that today would be considered the ultimate heavy metal logo. But back in the day, they took the album and the design and everything, and at the last minute changed it with a different logo. That's just that SS looking thing that was clunky and didn't have any reason for being on that cover. One of my best friends is Burton Cummings from The Guess Who. I did my first album for them in 1972 for Artificial Paradise. And I think I've done probably 7 or 8 albums for him. Black Oak Arkansas, I think I did 6. Alice Cooper 13. A lot of the bands would keep coming back to us. Some bands were one time and that was it. The Rolling Stones, they never used the same artist twice on any projects. They always go to somebody new, somebody different, somebody fresh. And so I was very lucky in that case to be able to do the logo. Went to Craig Braun to show him my work. I told you that I had this aggressive headhunter that was constantly putting me places to make the money because I came a show dog for him. You know, he was the guy that would make it happen. And so I went to this interview, and Craig was just describing the whole situation and how I needed to take this record label graphic, which was a pair of lips, and go up to his art department and draw a tongue on the outside of it. He said, I think I could sell this to the Stones. So I did that. It took me about 15 or 20 minutes. He sold it to Marshall Chess, who sold it to the Stones, and I got a job and $200. I really love doing the lettering, and that's become, along with the concept and design, lettering has become something that's really been good for me. With Pacific Ioneer, I did 189 album covers. And after Pacific Ioneer ended, that was in a 14 and a half year period. After Pacific Ioneer ended, I continued with other companies that I started, and I continued doing album covers. Yeah, out of the 236 albums, it's really hard to remember all of them. The ones you tend to remember are like The Doors and Alice Cooper. I've done 13 albums for Alice. Aerosmith. Black Sabbath. I'm sorry. Which one? Oh, yeah. Can we cut that piece out?